What's going on, guys? So on today's podcast, as you can tell, we have a different scenery behind this. What's behind you guys?
AutoZone. In Sabinas.
Hidalgo.
Nuevo León.
We
are here. That is right. We are here in Sabinas, Hidalgo, Nuevo León. Beautiful scenery behind us all. We have our guest here. We have Sar Sariel. You guys know him. And we have Sariel. Sariel, why don't you go ahead and let people know about yourself? Where are you from, man?
Shit, I was born in L.A. Live in Indiana. Went there all of high school and shit. I grew up there, basically. But I used to live in L.A. too. I left that place. It was cool, but it wasn't for me.
So you're in Fort Wayne now, right?
Yeah. But I'm barely ever there, though. I'm barely ever there.
What do you think about that state?
It's cool. It's not all that bad. It's just the snow. And I just noticed that a lot of people who complain about it, they never get the fuck out of there.
Yeah, they just stay there.
You just stay there. Like, you got to get out for a little bit. Shit.
So what you do for a living, man?
Shit. I just really do like tattooing, but it's not like really tattoos. I do cosmetic tattoos, if you guys know or familiar with that. So permanent makeup, to be exact. And I get a lot of questions like, why permanent makeup? Well,
for the slow people, he does tattoo for eyebrows.
And I'm about to start doing lips too. So it goes way back when I was in middle school. So during roasting sessions in middle school, people would come at me for my unibrow. And then that's when I started getting my brows done, threaded and shit. Not threaded, but plucked. And then ever since, I've just been getting them done. I learned how to do them on my own through YouTube. And I know how to fucking do them good on my own. And then I seen a video of them getting tattooed. And I said, fuck it, I can do it. I'm a perfectionist. So I got into it. And that's just what I do now. Shit, I don't really like go to work or anything. I just do it on my own time. And
is it going good so far for you, though?
It's going good, but it can be better if I actually took the time to.
You need to advertise a little bit more.
Advertise, basically. Actually do it more. Yeah. Get a little shot, because I really be out the way, so I don't have time to do it as much as I want to. But I'm gonna start taking that shit serious now.
See, man, you're out a lot. You do a lot of traveling. You were just recently in Cancun. How was that?
Cancun is fucking crazy. Crazy as hell. I love it.
Why you gotta bring Cancun up? Dude was talking non-stop about Cancun.
I love like Cancun.
Every time we bring up Cancun. Oh, yeah, Cancun was so dope. Oh, that shit, bro.
Man, I love Cancun. I can't wait to go back. I will be back this year. Maybe two more times, but for sure once. But
when do you plan on going back?
July. And maybe for my birthday, but maybe not. I don't know.
You guys about to go deep or what?
Who knows? You finna turn up, though.
Turn up. So, Sar, how was your first time in Mexico, man?
Yet again, I left Fort Wayne at the exact right time. I escaped another snowstorm.
There's a snowstorm right there. It's like 7 degrees over there.
Look at me, bro. Shorts, shirt. I'm living the life. Everything's cheap as fuck here. And I love it because it reminds me of Thailand. It's like home.
It's like 88 degrees here, ain't it?
I just fucked my back sweaty as fuck talking about it.
We living good over here. Eating tacos, tortas, all that good stuff.
That real shit. They didn't have as good food in Cancun. It was cool, but it wasn't like that real authentic stuff you want from Mexico. So if you go to Cancun, don't expect to get that shit down there.
We're currently sitting at one of the best restaurants in Sabinas, behind Tony.
Here in Sabinas, Hidalgo, they got some good food, man. Authentic. You can't get enough of it. What do you think's the best food you've ate so far down here?
The best food I've ate so far was dinner today. I had that milanesa.
Yeah, today. What was our meal called?
Something out of cheddar. That shit was good.
Smack.
So, you guys both do traveling, you know, here and there, but to the people that are just stuck in Fort Wayne and don't want to go out to travel anywhere, what do you have to say to them?
Man, get the fuck out of there, man. Go somewhere. Stop spending your money on dumb shit and go book a flight, get your passport and go.
Go experience stuff.
Go experience life. Shit.
And don't be scared to travel alone.
Yeah, don't be scared.
Just because your friends doesn't want to go, that doesn't mean you shouldn't go. Yeah. Like, they're just stopping you from seeing the outside world.
You're going to be waiting your whole life if you do that.
Don't wait on anybody that says,
don't wait on these cappers, bro.
Yeah, they're capping. They don't
want to
go.
Don't wait on these cappers.
Book the flight without them. Do what you got to do. Because tell them, Sariel, there's a lot of cappers out there.
There's a lot of cappers out there. Tony, tell them, am I a capper?
Nah, Sariel's not a capper. This dude, I'm about to go on a trip and I ask him, man, I say, hey, you want to come with me somewhere? And he'll be like, yeah, man, I'll go with you.
Tell him about
out of the blue, man.
Wait, now it's my turn. Am I a capper? Your grandpa literally told you to go to Mexico with them during my podcast. Yeah, and he was like, yeah, my grandpa told me to go to Mexico. And I was like, all right, bet, let's go. And now we're here.
Yeah, during my podcast, my grandpa called me. He said, I'm going to Mexico tomorrow. So last minute. And I called. Well, Sar was with me there. And he's like, dude, can you go? He was like, can I go? I was like, yeah, dude, come on. I thought he was lying. And then I called Sariel. I said, you trying to go? He's like, never.
Hey, tell him about me, though. What happened?
This dude, I just got back from Cancun literally the day before. And then he said, yeah, I'll go.
I just got done unpacking and shit. Did laundry. I get a call from this dude. Not even 12 hours before we got to go. And I said, fuck it. I started packing that next morning.
He wasn't even home a full day.
I wasn't even home a full day. But fuck it, though. Like, why not? I got the time and shit. So, why not? I love it here. I'm going to come back.
I'm just glad that we came during the winter storm. Because I hate the snow. I hate the cold. I don't like dealing with it. But look, man, we're here now. We're here with this beautiful scenery.
Literally, like a day after we got here, I started seeing everybody snap in the fort. Fucking inches of snow. Crazy. I was so glad I was here.
What was that? Somebody had the strap?
I thought that was the cartel, bro.
Oh, shit.
I was ready to run.
Damn. But, yeah, how you guys like it here so far?
Man, I love it.
Damn.
Anyways, yeah, I like it here. I wanted to explore like the city a little more because I didn't get to in Cancun. Because basically, the resorts is just one strip, but it's lit still. But I wanted to see like everyday life, and it's dope as hell. And shit, we gonna go to Monterrey tomorrow. Can't wait for that. It's gonna be crazy.
Me? I love it here because it reminds me of Thailand. You know, my homeland. We were supposed to go to Thailand this year, but fucking COVID stopped us from going.
COVID messed everything up, man. I hate COVID.
Hey, at least Tony's homeland is fucking open for me. So I had to come, you know? I had to see the world.
Yep.
It reminds me of my home, so yeah, I'm loving it.
I just never want to come here, but Cancun,
not bad.
Cancun made me kind of rethink. Like, maybe you should go visit other places. And just, god damn it, I do want to go to more places in Mexico.
So we went hiking yesterday. How was that? You guys fucked with it or not?
It was cool, but I wasn't prepared for it. It was nice though.
I'll have to throw some pictures on the screen for them to see, some little clips.
Man, last time we went to Angel's Landing, I was preparing myself for like 3 weeks. You know, hitting the gym and shit. Yesterday, I wasn't prepared for that shit at all. At all.
It was normal for me. Used to it.
Not me.
I was hungry as fuck towards the end. Hungry to the point where I was about to pass out.
But was it worth it with the view or not?
It was worth it in the end.
Yeah. A lot of cow shit up there, wasn't there?
A lot of cow shit. I don't know how the hell they got up there. Shit crazy.
Well.
So, yeah. If you ever think about traveling, just do it. That's all I gotta say to you. Just do it.
And if I fuck with you, hit me up. I'll fucking go.
Yeah, shit. Like, if you wanna go, hit me up. I'll go. I ain't capping. I'll go.
Man, we out here world traveling. There's them baby ass dudes that go to Vegas and Cali and be like, oh yeah, I'm doing big things out here. Tell them, Sariel.
And that ain't
that's down here, bro. Hey. We up here with it.
Hey, we cool off the States.
No. I mean, the if you haven't traveled the States, it's cool. Go travel the States. I did all that last year, though.
The States are right. The States are cool. But once you travel outside the U.S., you'll realize, damn, I'm missing out.
Definitely. It was cool last year. I traveled like nine times last year. And one was only international to the Bahamas. The rest were in the States. So it's cool. It's cool. You know, it's nice. But this year, I really want to just do international trips strictly. You know, do something different. Go see the rest of the world.
Tell them, Sario. Fuck that Gucci belt. Fuck all that Tommy shit. Fuck all that. Go buy a plane ticket.
That's my mindset now. Like, before I'm about to buy some dumbass shit, I just be like, dang, I could use this money to buy a flight here or there. And I do it. So.
Don't wait on nobody.
But I'm blessed to be able to have friends that just say, fuck it, let's go.
Fuck it.
Sar, what do you do for a living? Drug dealer?
Well, I'm an electrician, but since I got into my accident like 5 months ago, I haven't been working. My only income from my investments on stocks, which is doing me great. And then my work was paying me weekly, but they stopped paying me, but shit, you know, when you got money, it's just whatever.
Yeah, go wherever you want, do whatever you want.
Do what you want, man. Go live that life. Eat that $80 steak, man. Nobody cares, bro. Just go do you. Do your thing. Just fuck everybody's feelings. Do you, man.
For sure.
That's the only thing I gotta say. Just do it, bro. Just do it.
What? And if you sing, and if you got a girlfriend, you gotta have to figure that out, buddy.
Yeah.
Hey. If your girl ain't willing to go half-half, that ain't your girl, bro. Like, if you want to travel, get a girl that's willing to go half-half.
Half-half?
Because if you find a girl that expects you to pay everything, that ain't a woman, bro. That's just a...
That's a kid you gotta take care of?
That's just a kid you gotta take care of on God, bro.
A liability. Nah, but if she cold and she cool and she not asking me for shit, I'll fucking fly her somewhere and shit. I'll do that. Not for anyone, though.
She gotta be the right one?
Yeah, she gotta be the right one for me to do all that. See, when I was younger, I probably would have done it for just anybody.
Damn, not no more, though,
Not
huh?
no more. I
done learned my... the mindset.
I done learned my lesson. Hella times. Back in high school.
You wanna tell us a story about some stingy females that you've messed with in the past? You don't gotta bring up no names, but if you got a story to tell, man, you can tell it.
Yeah, I mean, not a story, but I've had my run-ins with. If you're not spending money, then you're not finna get no play. So I'm not finna trick off on just anybody.
Would you say all these females care about is money?
Not all. Not
most
all.
Of them. A good majority?
I'd say in the States, a lot of them do.
Yeah.
I can't speak for all, but the ones I know that I've run into, yeah. But yeah, I'm not all though, not all. What you think?
I just want a wife out of the States.
Hell yeah, me too. Me too, a wife out of the States.
I'm sorry, but all these girls in the fort is just not it.
Oh, hell no.
This is not
You gotta it. Travel, buddy. And go see the world, man.
I damn near just found the girl of my dreams here.
Tell them the
story. I don't know Spanish, so I missed out.
Tell them the story about what happened today earlier.
All right, so you see these two? These two speak Spanish, all right? I don't understand shit. But today I saw a girl at the grocery store, and I was like, fuck it. I told her to hold my shit. I went up to her. I was like, hola, tú es muy bonita. And she was like, oh, gracias, gracias. And she started saying some crazy shit. I was like, what? And then, like, she was, it had, like, poco in it. Poco means, like, what? Like, a little? A
little bit, yeah.
Yeah, and then she was like, tú sabes? I was like, no. And I was like, ¿tienes Facebook, Instagram? She was like, nah. I was like, fuck. And I was like, ¿tienes a number? She was like, all right. And then I got her number. Now I gotta get girls for them by telling her to bring some friends over.
Not me.
You don't gotta get me.
Oh, he got a girl. But yeah, just saying.
Well, I wish you luck with that, man. I really do.
Yeah,
I hope you get some buns.
Yeah, for sure.
You gonna take her back to the States?
Nah.
Nah. Why?
It ain't like that. She damn near just talked to me just for the papers, no cap.
Damn. Could be, man. Could be.
Shit. Yeah.
What about you, Sario? You looking for somebody in the States or out of the States? Or what kind of female are you looking for, man?
Colombian. Nah, not real shit, but... A nice Mexican one from here would be nice. From here. Latina, really. That's it. Preferably Colombian, though. Dude, I haven't been out there.
Dude, fuck relationship. Just travel, bro.
Damn.
Hey, like that?
You'll save a lot of money, sorry. You'll save a lot of money.
Dude, why you gotta worry about falling in love, bro? Just travel.
Oh, I'm not worried about that shit. I'm not worried about that shit
fuck
at all.
Fuck love, bro. I wanna go to Dubai. I'll go to Dubai, bro. Fuck love.
No cap. Not that I'm hurt or anything, but... I'm not worried about that right now.
Nah,
bro. Damn.
I'm only 23. What the fuck do I look like getting tied down right now?
See, you just gotta travel, bro. When you start traveling, you realize, damn, I'm really missing out.
I feel like all the places that I've been to so far, man, I just feel like the more you travel, the more it opens up your mind. You see different shit.
Different people. You see different places. You see... what people go through in other places, and you just realize, damn.
Because people that just stay in their hometown, that's all that they're known to is just that. There's same people, same shit every day. And you go see different things, you're like, damn, there's more than that little ass town that I'm in. There's people do this in different countries. People do this in different states. It's crazy. So much shit that's out there, dude. Crazy.
And one time a few weeks ago, I was at my dude's house. And this dude was over here about to cry and shit because his girl left him.
Hell no, fuck all that.
And I was like, bro, I'm like, he asked me, like, how would I get over it? Me being me, I was like, man, do you travel a lot? I'm like, I really don't. I'm like, bro, go book a flight to Miami or something or somewhere else. You're going to see a lot of women from all over the world. Women you didn't even know existed. Man, just go get out the fucking state.
Go get some traveling in, man.
You're gonna meet a lot of women around the world. And you're gonna get over her fast. That's what I told dude.
So Sariel, man, what's your overall goals are in life? Are you where you wanna be at right now?
Hell no.
What do you wanna improve on?
What would I wanna improve on? Time management. Right now I'm just like, fuck it, like I'm just all over the place. I don't got much of a schedule, like whatever pops up I do. So I want to like organize my life a little bit better.
That's good though, because you don't got no kids, really nothing to worry about right now. So
so it all balances out right now.
Yeah,
but
you don't got nothing to worry about.
I need a routine because right now I'm just going with the flow and just out the way.
What about you, Sar? You got any life goals, man? What's going on with you?
Life goals. I want to end up not working for anybody. I want to be my own boss and just travel, you know?
Work for yourself?
Yeah, I want to let my money work for me. I'm just going to travel, you know?
That's good.
And I will do this. I will be my own boss by the age of 30. On God, I promise you.
Before that?
Even before that, yeah. Like, I'm only 20 right now. Dude, give me like 5-6 years. I promise you, I won't work under anybody.
I hope it goes like that, man. I really do.
Yeah, like I feel like working my own schedule, doing what I want to do, taking the days off how I want to take off. I think that's the best way for me, because I couldn't imagine asking someone, can I go here, and they tell me no. Like, what the fuck?
That's me, bro. I don't need any permission, bro. I don't want to ask any permission for anything. If I want it, if I want to do it, if I want to go there, I'm going to do it.
For sure.
That's my goal, bro.
100%.
So if you were to get in a relationship and you're all your dudes invited you out to go somewhere, let's say like Bora Bora or something like that, and your girl said, "No, you can't go unless you take me." What would be your response to that?
It depends.
What do you mean? Like when I get rich or like
no, just right
sometime
now.
Sometime soon, yeah, like sometime just soon.
In general.
Well, shit, if you want to come, then yeah, I'll take you, but you paying your half, like the fuck? Like, nah.
It all depends, you know, like, if she's...
Yeah, but like he said, it all depends. Like, if I actually love this girl, if I actually, like, see potential or, like, shit like that, I'll take her on that trip.
Yeah, it just depends on the dynamic.
I don't want to be the one, like, paying everything forever, you know?
Yeah, it just depends on the dynamics of the relationship.
I want my type of girl, like, I'm not looking for a relationship, but, like, I'm just saying... My type of girl would be that independent, you know? That's biggest thing in a girl, bro.
Yeah.
What about you, Saria? Same thing?
It just depends on a dynamic or relationship. Like, if it's just a boys trip, then fuck it, I'll go. I mean...
Yeah, if it's just the boys trip, I'm gonna be like, nah, this is the boys trip. Yeah. I'm gonna go. If you're finna break up with me, then go on.
Like,
then.
If you're just trying to go see, like, trying to babysit me, no, fuck that.
Yeah, fuck that.
So guys, what's your next plan? What's your next vacation plan? Where are you guys headed?
Sheesh.
After Mexico, I know we'll probably go to the fort and chill for a little bit, but after that, what you guys got planned?
Alright, so I already got 3 trips this year. This is my 3rd one.
Of this year?
Yeah. It's already the second month of the year. And I already got 3 trips. 2 in Mexico, but now I think I'm gonna just chill out. For the next few couple months, save my money, and probably do a small little trip here in the spring. But once summer comes, I'm gonna go crazy. I'm gonna go crazy in the summer.
Where are you going?
You'll see.
We'll see. Surprise! You'll see. Surprise!
Yeah, surprise! I'm gonna go harder this time.
It's good, man. What about you, Sar? Where you headed, man?
Dude. Anything? To be honest, I've been traveling more since I got injured than I wasn't injured, dude. I'm going to be honest with you.
So you're a drug dealer?
No. But I actually got a lot of places I want to go this year. But next month, I got to go to Texas for the streetcar takeover. In May, I want to go to New York City. In June, I got to go to Las Vegas when I turn fucking 21. Blow all my money there. And then July, we're going to Cancun. And I don't know, I hope I like it there. I heard great stories from him every fucking day since I'm here. And then
you'll love it.
I'm serious, this dude talks about is Cancun.
Not all the time.
It sounds like the spot.
Not all the time, but it was lit as fuck.
I did want to go back to Thailand, but fucking COVID ruined everything. You know, I had so much planned back in Thailand that I wanted to go do. But, hey, that 2022, I hope COVID is lifted and I hope I can travel more in 2022. And I for sure want to get back to work, though, because I'm going to need that moolah soon.
Is there anybody you guys want to give a shout-out to, or you want to shout-out any of your social media accounts to sponsor yourself?
I want to give a big shout-out to Evelyn.
You want to put her IG up there?
I don't even know.
Put your finger. Yeah, put your finger.
I don't know what her Instagram name is. I think it's Art by Eve. She gave me a hat and I fucking forgot it. So I can wear it in Mexico. I fucking forgot it. I took in a nap right before we got on the plane. No. I took a nap before I went to go pick Jorge up so we can go to the airport. And I fucking left it on my bed. So I didn't get to take it to Cancun and take a picture with it, but I'm gonna definitely get a shirt from her, cop a shirt from her, have that bitch inked out and shit, wait for my next one.
Good,
so
man,
I appreciate
good.
It
what about you, sorry, shouting anybody out yourself?
I want to shout out to my main friends.
Who's that?
I mean, but like my 2 main friends, they're girls, Vicky and Fatima.
You want to put their IGs up there or anything like that, or they want to be secretive?
They know who they are, bro. They know
okay.
who they are.
Okay.
But yeah, them two just, they're just the two that understands me the most, you know? Like, I go places, I do all of that, you know, they're always proud of me no matter what I do. And they're always there for me when I'm down, you know? So shout out to them. And when I got here, they were happy as fuck that I'm here, even though they didn't come with me. That's why I love them. But yeah, I hope they were here with me, and shout out to them.
It's good, man. I appreciate you guys for coming on.
Oh, wait. And then I started a travel/vlog channel. So go follow. It'll be like right here. Finding Sar.
All right, man. Appreciate you guys for coming on. Hopefully I can have you guys on soon again. Have a nice day, guys.
How long can I survive with this mentality?